Hey there, my name is Chaitanya Goyal and I've been playing CS for more than 8 years and I own a dedicated server for more than 5 years. I will be teaching you how to create your own Counter-Strike 1.6 dedicated server, and this is the part 1 of the tutorial. So what is a dedicated server? Basically there are two types of server. One is from online hosting, which are paid server, and other is the home dedicated server, which you can create for free. There is no difference between these servers. Both can be used to play with your friends or random people from Steam or non-Steam. So why choose the paid one? You can skip the non-Steam installation part if you just want to connect with Steam clients. Unlike other tutorials, which are outdated and doesn't work anymore because things have changed a lot in the past few years, this tutorial will make you set up the latest build of the server with the official latest build engine from Valve. Because previous builds are no more shown in the internet list and in the Steam list. I will keep updating the tutorial if there are any changes in the setting up of the latest build, which possibly aren't gonna happen for the next few years or maybe decades. I would also recommend to give the server installation a fresh start if you have already visited another tutorial and have done some stuff on the same. Because from my 5 years of experience, there is no other tutorial which teaches a 100% working server with the latest build engine. So the first step, the first thing you will need to make your Counter-Strike 1.6 server is patience, which according to Wikipedia is a state of endurance under difficult circumstances, which can mean preserving in the face of delay or provocation without acting blah blah blah. You know what is patience. Okay, you are gonna need that because you just can't create a server in 5 minutes. It's not a 5 minute deal. If you want to create a server in 5 minutes, this video is not for you, and you probably aren't gonna make in 5 minutes. You need at least a whole day, at least a whole day. Okay, so you need patience. So I hope you will enjoy and you are gonna learn a lot from this video. I will also make it a beginner friendly tutorial. Now enough of the introduction and let's just get started. The first thing you will need is Steam CMD. Steam CMD is a Valve software which will download all the necessary files needed for your Counter-Strike server. We will download it from valvesoftware.com, which is the official Valve site. And we will download it for Windows. It's gonna start. I'll open. I will extract it to my desktop. Now I will move the Steam CMD folder to my C drive. You can use any drive you want, but I will be using C drive. Now to get the Counter-Strike 1.6 files needed for your server, you need a script that will tell Steam CMD to download those files. And I have this script prepared. You can either download it from the link description below or pause the video and write it yourself. That's your wish. I will paste this in my Steam CMD folder. Now I will create a desktop shortcut of Steam CMD. Now I will go to the properties of the shortcut and type space plus run script space hlds.txt. Click on apply and then hit OK. Now I will run Steam CMD through the shortcut. Now it will download all the necessary files needed to create your server in the Steam CMD folder in the C drive. Now I'm just gonna wait till the time it downloads. It finished up so quickly. Something wrong must have happened. Let me check. Yeah, it's of size 49.2 MB. But it should be approx 450 MB. So I'm gonna run Steam CMD again. Yeah, it's downloading now. And it have completely installed. Let's check it out. What's the size? It's of 752 MB. So make sure you get approx 752 MB of the Steam CMD folder. Otherwise it won't work. Okay. So this is the installation of Steam CMD. Basically the downloading of Steam CMD from the Valve. You will need to create a backup of the Steam CMD folder. In case you do something stupid, you won't have to download all the 750 MB again. So I'll name Steam CMD backup and paste here. This ends the part 1 of the tutorial. The link for the part 2 must be on your screen or in my playlist. Please do watch the part 2 to continue the installation. Thank you.